Hello friends, welcome to you. Please like, share and subscribe this channel. Now today I am going to take up the numericals on steam nozzles. Again, I am taking these questions from the question bank. On steam nozzle, I have selected a few questions. Question number one. A nozzle is to be designed to expand steam at the rate of 0.1 kg per second, that is mass of steam to be discharged is 0.10 kg per second, this is the this thing, from, that is P1, the steam enters the nozzle at 500 kilopascal pressure, 500 kilopascal, and at 210 degrees centigrade to 100 kilopascal, that is P3 is 100 kilopascal, the exit pressure is 100 kilopascals, neglect inlet velocity, that is V1 is not considered, for a nozzle efficiency of 0.9 or 90%, determine the exit area. Find A3 is what is asked. So this is a problem on nozzle and this is to be solved. Now here what type of nozzle it is not given. It may be any type of nozzle. It doesn't make any difference for us. It doesn't make any difference whether it is convergent nozzle, divergent nozzle or even convergent divergent nozzle. It doesn't matter. Here they have given these inlet pressure, they have given the discharge, they have given asked us to find the exit area. Now this should be converted into bars first. P1 is 500 kilopascal means 5 bar, 100 kilopascal means it is 1 bar. So P1 entrance pressure is 1 bar, exit pressure is 1 bar. Right. Now it is at the entrance, it is superheated, its temperature is 210 degrees centigrade. Now what we do is we have to find out, first we have to find out V3, you know, is root of 2000 into H1 minus H3. This is the enthalpy at entrance, this is the enthalpy at exit. Now this enthalpy at exit and entrance have to be found out by using Mollier chart. You take the Mollier chart, see where is 5 bar. 5 bar is somewhere here, 5 bar pressure 210 degree centigrade. It is not there, only we have 200 then 250. So it is somewhere in between that. So 5 bar pressure, this is the 5 bar pressure. Here what you do is you roughly mark here, this is 5 bar line, this is 210 degrees centigrade temperature line, this is saturation line, so this is H1, you mark like this roughly, no necessity to do this. Now corresponding to this, the this thing is for 5 bar 210, it is somewhere around 2800 and so 2900. So I'll take H1 as 2850. You can take it roughly, you mark here, this is H1, I have taken here, this is 5 bar, this is P1, this is T-soup 1, mark like this. Next, the exit pressure is 1 bar. So 1 bar, you mark like this. You mark a vertical line like this. You simply mark this is 1 bar. 1 bar. Now, what is H3? 1 bar is here, 210. 5 bar is somewhere here. Come down here till you get 1 bar. And now, this is now 2580 or something like that. H3 is 2580. 2580 kilojoules per kg, something like that. And X3 is 0.92, something like that. This is 0.92, let us say. Roughly, it need not be very accurate. You can't be very accurate here. You have to take like that. So this is P3. This is X3. This is H3. You have taken it as 2580. This is 2850 kilojoules per kg. Then substitute here. So V3 is equal to under root 2000 into 2850 minus 2580. Now this will give you roughly what will you get? 2850 minus 2580 equals 270 into 2000 equals this much. Square root of answer will give you 734.8. We can take it as 735 meters per second. This is the exit velocity. This is the velocity with which it comes out. So we got V3. Next he wants A3. So for finding A3, we have to use the relationship discharge. MS is equal to A3 V3 divided by X3 VG3. So this will be A3 will be equal to MS into X3 VG3 divided by V3. So MS we want is 0.1, X3 is something like 0.92 into VG3 we will see, V3 is 735. VG3 I will find from the steam table corresponding to P3. P3 is 1 bar. So for 1 bar, what is this thing? We'll see here. For one bar, VG is 1.694. Right. So that will give me 0.1 into 0.92 into 1.694 divided by 735. That will be 2.12. That will be equal to 2.12 into 10 to the power of minus 4 square meters. If you want to give it in square millimeter, into 1000 into 1000 or into 10 to the power of 6 will give me 212 square millimeter. This should be the exit area. So this is how it should be done. This is a problem on first type, that is where we are not interested in what type of nozzle it is. Next, we'll take up one more problem. On convergent divergent nozzle, we'll take one problem. Uh, I'll take one more problem. Problem number 2. Steam enters a convergent divergent nozzle. Now it is on convergent divergent nozzle at 2 MPa. That means P1 is 2 MPa. Means 2000 kilopascals, or it is 20, this thing, 2 MPa and 400 degree centigrade. So T soup 1 is 400 degree centigrade, right, with a negligible velocity. That means V1 is very little. You can, mass flow MS is 2.5 kg per second. This is what we want. And it comes out at a pressure of 300 kilopascal. P3 is 300 kilopascal. That is the discharge pressure, or back pressure it is called. The flow is isentropic between the nozzle and entrance, nozzle, entrance and throat, and overall efficiency is 93%. Overall efficiency, nozzle efficiency is 93%. That is 0.93. This is 3 bar, this is 20 bar, T soup 1 is this much. So first I have to find out P2. Now P2 by P1 here for maximum discharge should be 0.546, because steam is initially superheated. So P2, what is P2? Throat pressure is 0.546 multiplied by P1. That is 0.546 into 20. That means it is around 11 bar. 0.546 into 20 means it is 10.92 bar. You can take it as approximately 11 bar. This is P2. P3 we know. P3 is 3 bar. 20 bar is pressure at entrance. At throat it is 11 bar. At here it is 3 bar. Now you have these Mollier chart. So P1, T soup 1, this is 20 bar, this is 400 degree centigrade. So what is H1? We have to find out. So 20 bar, take this 20 bar line. Where is 20 bar? This is 20 bar. 20 bar, 400 degree centigrade. It is somewhere around 3250. 3250 kilojoules per kg. H2, that means here 11 bar. This is P2, 11 bar. So somewhere here, from here 20 bar, 400 degree centigrade, they are meeting here, somewhere here. 20 bar, from here you come up to 11 bar. Is not there, 10 bar. It is still superheated. Come vertically down, 20 bar (400°C) come vertically down 11 bar. It is somewhere around 3000 kilojoules per kg. Then P3 is 3 bar. This is only rough. Further extend it. This is H3, this is H2. H3, 3 bar. It is somewhere here, 1, 2, 3 bar. It is 2700 kilojoules per kg. You come up to here, then what we are asked to find is throat and exit areas. So for that, what we have to do, V2 is root of 2000 to H1 minus H2, no initial velocity, into efficiency you put here, because there is some loss. 93% means 7% loss is there. 2000 into 3250 minus 3000 into 0.93. (3250) minus approximately 3000, that will give me 250 into 0.93 into 2000 equals this much. A square root of answer equals 682, approximately 682 meters per second. Then V3 will be root of 2000 H1 minus H3 into efficiency, 2000 into 3250 minus 2700 into 0.93, 3250 minus 2700 equals into 0.93 into 2000 equals under root equals 1011 meters per second. This is V3. Then you use the formula MS is equal to A2 V2 divided by X2 VG2. So A2 will be equal to MS X2 VG2 divided by V2. You have got these values. Similarly, A3 will be equal to MS X3 VG3. You take X2 and X3 as 1 or 1 point something, because it is still superheated. So divided by V3. So you have got these values, or you can take X2, X3 as 1. At least it is dry, and you will get this as so many square meters. A2 and A3 you will get as so many square meters. Kitna hua hai? So finding A2 will be equal to MS. MS is 2.5 into X2, I'll take as 1.1. into VG2 from steam table. I will take VG2 means for 11 bar. VG2 for 11 bar is 0.1774 divided by V2 I got as 682. So this will be equal to 2.5 into, I have taken it as 1.1 into 0.1774 divided by 682 equals 7.15 into 10 to the power of minus 4, so many square meters, or it will be 715 square mm. Next, exit area. This is the throat area. Exit area must be greater than this. So I have to find out V3. For V3, A3, I have this formula. A3 will be equal to, MS remains the same, 2.5. X3 I will take as 1 as 1.02 or something like that. Into VG3, this is 1011. VG3 for 3 bar. For 3 bar, VG3 is 0.6057 divided by 1011. So if I calculate this, 2.5 to 1.02 into 0.6057 divided by 1011. If I do it, it is 1.52 into 10 to the power of minus 3 square meters, or it will be 1527 square mm, that is greater than this. So that means it is correct. So this is how these problems have to be solved. I have done two problems. You please solve some more problems. If you have find any difficulty, you can always contact me on phone, or you can comment. You can send the problem to me if you have any problem. In any difficulty, you can send it to me. I shall solve and give it to you. Thank you.